Hey, Westside, it's exciting to be able to come to you and be a part of what God is doing in here in your church family at Eden Westside. Man, last weekend was a spiritual marathon. We had so many things going on, the celebration, the ABC Conference of Evangelism. And by the way, how about Sunday night? It was a knockout at the River Campus. Man, there was so much going on there. 209 people at the River Campus Sunday night. Woohoo! What a blessing. What a victory, man. It was just exciting to be part of what God is doing there. And then Sunday morning, we just had visitors everywhere and people making decisions. And I'm excited about how God is moving among us. So today, I just want to thank God for how He's working among us here at Eden Westside and all the decisions that are being made and all the lives that are being changed. Man, it's just a blessing to see how the Lord is at work. Now, you can tell that I'm right here working at the desk, and I'm getting ready for this coming Sunday, and I expect for us to see a lot of things happening this coming Sunday as well. You know, there's just so much going on that it would take a lot of time to tell you about with all the exciting things that's happening. One of the things that I'm just really joyful about is our deaf congregation and how it's growing. And man, it's amazing how the Lord is working in the body here to bring so many people, diverse, different groups here at Eden Westside. And it's a joy to be a part of that. Adriana Webster made a decision Sunday for Christ and becoming part of the church. And Justin Funderburg gave his life to the Lord. You know, it took a lot of courage for Justin to step out and let it be known that he was a lost church member. Justin had sat in our church for years and was a member. And, you know, it's amazing. It's a time where you come to realize, wow, you know what? You can be in church every Sunday and be working in the church, but yet at the same time, not know Jesus as your Savior. And Justin stepped out and publicly let everybody know, you know what? He wasn't really authentically saved. He didn't really know Jesus as his Savior. And he made that decision on Sunday. And we all celebrated with Justin. We're excited about that. So today, when I think about that, I think the challenge from me to you this week is for you to search your heart. You know, it's not just about going to church. It's not just about religious stuff. It's not just about reading your Bible or praying. It's about a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And I encourage you to stop and search your heart. And really examine, do you really know Christ as your Savior? Do you really have a personal relationship with Him? And my prayer that I pray that you do, but if you honestly don't know, we want to help you with that. So I encourage you to think about it, pray about it, and if we can help you in that decision, we certainly want to do that. Well, this coming Sunday is going to be a great day. I can't wait to see you and your friend as you bring them to church with you. Make sure they come by and introduce themselves. I can't wait to meet them. God bless you. I'll see you then.